Daffodil bulb. It's kind of plain, nothing special about it. But if I plant it in the ground, water it, and wait, Jesus will make it into a beautiful flower.
If God could do that with a daffodil bulb, think what he could do with me.
Good morning, boys and girls. It's a beautiful Sunday. Hope you're feeling well and strong. You are happy. It's a beautiful day that God has given us, and we shall rejoice and be glad in it. Today is a very, very special day. You know why? Because George, he's just been having a funny, funny week. You remember what we talked about last time? Avoiding watching bad movies? Let's find out if he's been able to overcome the temptation to keep watching movies late at night. I hope, boys and girls, you stay tuned. George?
Yes?
How are you, George, today?
I'm not so good, Teacher Grace.
Oh. What happened? I hope you haven't watched a late movie.
No, I've not watched any bad movies. I learned my lesson.
Okay, so what is it this time?
It's my friend. You know my friend Brian?
Yes, I know Brian.
What did he do? His grandmother was very sick.
Okay.
She had, they call it diabetes.
Yes, diabetes.
And you know, she was such a wonderful lady.
Oh.
I would visit Brian and we would chat with her.
Yes.
But she died.
Oh, that's sad. Sorry, George, and sorry to your friend Brian. And we pray for comfort, for God's peace and strength at this time. I understand why you're sad. But you know, George, in the Bible we have a story about someone also who died.
Oh, there's a story about
yes.
sad story?
Yes, and there's always a happy ending in the Bible.
Okay.
Are you ready? Have you wiped your tears?
Just a minute.
Good. Take a sip of water and wipe your tears. Boys and girls, I think today we'll understand George is very emotional. And I know we'll all relate to what he's going through. Maybe you've lost a loved one and it's not an easy topic. But you know what? God gives peace. He gives comfort. And he really gives us strength at such times. And so, sorry, George. Are you okay now? Can you?
Yeah, I'm okay.
You can sit still and get to listen to the story?
Yes, yes.
Good, good. I know you're a good boy.
Thank you.
Today's story, it's about a young man called Lazarus.
Lazarus.
Lazarus. And Lazarus, he was a handsome man that had
handsome
three sisters.
Like me?
Well, maybe more.
You mean there's anyone more handsome than
Lazarus
me?
Lazarus was a young man and he had two sisters.
Okay.
And he came from a place called Bethany.
Bethany.
Bethany. And now Lazarus' family, with his two sisters, they were very good friends of Jesus.
What are the names of sisters?
Now his sisters were Martha.
Martha.
And Mary.
Okay, Mary.
Yes, so I think there were three in his family. There were three children.
Yeah.
That is Lazarus.
Mary and Martha.
And Martha. And Jesus was a good friend and he loved the Lazarus family.
It's good to have Jesus as
Isn't
a friend.
Isn't that so good? Imagine having Jesus as a friend. What would you do, George, if you had Jesus as a friend and he would visit you?
Oh, if he came to visit me? Oh, OK. okay, I think the first thing I would do, I would show him my toys,
okay.
And then I'll take him to my room,
yes.
And show him the pictures I've put on the wall.
Nice.
You know, I have all the superheroes.
Oh, good.
Like the Avengers.
Oh.
Yeah, and then I would show Jesus.
Uh-huh.
Okay, I would make him, I would give him a lollipop.
Okay.
And some cookies. Do you think he would like cookies?
I think Jesus would love cookies.
I would love him to visit me.
That would be so cool.
I would share my toys.
You're
with
a
him.
Good friend. You are definitely a good friend. Now Lazarus and his sisters, they loved Jesus and they hosted Jesus many times.
Okay.
But one day, Jesus was still with his disciples, helping people and visiting.
Okay.
And he visited their home. Because Lazarus was unwell.
Oh, Lazarus. Okay.
He had been unwell. And before that, you remember his sister Mary? Mary had poured some very expensive perfume on the feet of Jesus.
Oh, she poured perfume on Jesus.
On Jesus, and she wiped Jesus' feet with her hair. And it was very, very expensive and nice. It was smelling very nicely.
It must have been very expensive.
Yes, it was
and
a good
for her to wipe his feet.
Yes.
Maybe she knew who Jesus was.
She knew who Jesus was.
Lazarus was sick, and Jesus was far away.
Jesus was far away with his disciples.
Mm-hmm.
You know, doing what he used to do, walking
and helping
people. And healing and bringing those who are blind to see. And so Jesus did lots of good things. And so Mary and Martha, they went where Jesus was.
They sent someone to Jesus?
Yes. And he went and told Jesus, "Jesus, your friend is sick. The one you love is sick."
The one you love is sick.
Yes. And so
did Jesus go immediately?
No, Jesus did not go right away.
Why?
Because he knew that he would, you know, he would still go visit him, and he knew even if he got sick and he would raise him, he would.
It was an emergency, so he stayed. How many days did he stay?
He actually stayed for 2 more days.
Oh, and Lazarus, his friend, is sick.
And Lazarus, his best friend, was unwell, and he was so sick.
So
in
did
bed.
Lazarus remain okay
so
before
what
Jesus
happened,
came?
What happened is that Lazarus didn't get well. He got so badly sick
died. What?
He got worse and he
died. Did you say he died?
Yes, he just died.
Just like Brian's grandmother?
Just like Brian's grandmother.
Oh no.
And this time Lazarus had died. And Martha and Mary, they cried. And you know the way you feel sad?
Yeah, I've been crying with Brian.
They felt like they had already told Jesus and he had not come.
He delayed. Until it was too late.
They felt like Jesus had really taken so long.
Oh man, did they bury him?
So what happened? In those days, they used to bury right after someone had died.
Mm-hmm.
And so they buried Lazarus. And Jesus was still going on doing what he was doing.
Mm-hmm.
And you know what happened? After 4 days.
Yeah.
That's when Jesus came to Lazarus' home.
It was too late.
It was too late. He had already stayed.
He could not help his friend.
He had already stayed so long. And you know, his friend had already been buried somewhere in a tomb. And he had been wrapped and put somewhere it was a stone that was covering the whole place.
Poor Lazarus.
So Lazarus was just there lying. And his sisters and friends, they were all saying, well, had Jesus been here, he would have helped Lazarus.
Where was Jesus? Why did he delay?
Yeah, that's what they said. And now when Jesus came to their house,
yes,
Mary and Martha, they told Jesus, if you had been here, our brother Lazarus would not have died.
Yeah, you could have healed him.
You would have healed him. And you know what Jesus told them?
Mm-hmm.
That he is going to rise again.
He said he's going to rise again?
Yes, Jesus said he will rise again.
Wow!
Yes, because Jesus has all the power to raise the dead.
Even the dead.
Yes, and you know what?
Mm-hmm.
Jesus is the one who gives us life.
Yes.
And so what he did, he just told Lazarus, come forth.
He went to the grave,
to the tomb where Lazarus was lying.
Mm-hmm.
And he told Lazarus, come forth.
Yes, Lazarus,
and you
come
know what?
Forth.
Yes. And Lazarus...
But he was dead.
He was dead. But you know what? Jesus is able to rise you, to give your life back again.
Are you telling me...
Only Jesus can do that.
That 4 days dead, buried...
Yes.
He's going to rise again?
He rose again. 4 days, 10 days...
He rose again?
He rose again. Jesus would raise him again.
Wow, wow, wow.
Isn't that awesome?
Wow. Oh, my goodness.
Yes, and it's such a special...
Mary and Martha must have been so happy.
Now, when
happy.
They saw... Yes, you know what, George? When Martha and Mary saw Lazarus, he had been wrapped around with some white cloths, because that's when you are... When you're dead, that's how they would put you to rest.
They don't put... They were not... They did not have coffins or...
They didn't have coffins. They would take you where there is a stone and cover you with... cover the place with a stone. I think it was a placement for those that are dead.
It's a very sad place.
Yes, a very sad place. And there was no life.
Okay.
And so what they did, after Jesus had... he had already told Lazarus to come forth, and he rolled away the stone, and Lazarus came out. You know, he had to jump up. He couldn't walk because his hands, his legs were tied.
You know, Teacher Grace,
yes.
If I was near there, I could have run away the fastest
yes,
I can.
Yes, I don't think it was such a beautiful sight, because he was already smelly, and he had been wrapped around. But guess what? He came out of the place, and he started coming forth to where Jesus was, and his sisters were so happy
to have their brother
their brother back, and they knew that Jesus would bring him back to life again.
What a story.
Oh, I tell you, it gives us hope. You know, even if situations may seem like it's all lost, that Jesus will still come in the right time.
Yes.
And he will bring a change. He will bring life back. And you know what? In his word, he says that Jesus is our hope. He wipes away our tears. He comforts. And you know, just like he resurrected and he rose again, he promises that if we follow him, he's going to give us life.
So even Brian's grandma,
yes,
you know, she was a Christian. She loved God.
Oh, she loved Jesus.
Do you think she's going to rise again?
When the trumpets sound, and when Jesus will be coming to take his children, Brian's grandmother will be there.
That makes me feel happy.
Yes, there is hope.
That even though she has left us,
yes,
we will see her again.
We will
see
her
again.
When
all those people who love Jesus rise again,
when they rise
including
again.
My own grandpa,
yes,
and my grandpa, everyone who loves Jesus.
Everyone who loves
will rise again.
Will rise again.
It's such a wonderful feeling, Teacher Grace.
It's
I'm so happy.
It's such a wonderful feeling. And even
I
if
want
you feel
Jesus
sad,
to be my friend. I don't want to
Jesus
ever, ever
friend.
Let go of him so that I will not have to die.
Amen. Amen. I think boys and girls have heard our story today. We just encourage you that take heart. Know that Jesus understands and he cares about the time that you're going through. And you know what? You're not alone. He is going to hold you, he's going to carry you, and you're going to be strong again.
Amen.
We understand when you have to cry like George, we understand when you really feel like you want to be alone. And those are the times when you tell a friend or you tell your parent to pray with you because you miss your mom or you miss your grandparent or your dad. And remember, we love you so much, and we are praying with you. Even for those that have lost, you know, their loved ones at this time of during the COVID season, we are praying with you. And you know what? God's strength and power is going to touch your lives now more than ever. Are we ready for our memory verse?
Okay.
Good. Our memory verse today is from John chapter 11, verse 25, and it says, "I am the resurrection and the life."
Who said those words?
Guess who said those words?
Is Jesus?
Jesus.
Did Jesus say those words?
Jesus said he is the resurrection and the life. He who believes in him, he will live.
He will live and not
he will
die.
Live and not die.
Ooh.
And you know, dying is only in this life. And one day when you go to heaven, there will be no more dying.
We shall be with him forevermore.
We shall be with him forevermore. So be strong. And boys and girls, we pray that God will give you strength and know that we shall live forevermore when Jesus comes for us.
Amen.
Amen. God bless you so much. Are you ready for us to pray? Okay, let's close our eyes. Our Heavenly Father, we thank you for a wonderful story, oh God. A story that gives us hope that even if we've lost our loved ones, like Lazarus had died, that there is hope in you, we shall get to see our loved ones again. Help us to be strong. Help us to have faith in you that you will do it again when you come back for your children. Help those that are feeling sad and lonely at this time. Comfort them and give them your peace, O Lord. We thank you and honor you. Bless all the boys and girls. Bless their parents and bless each one of us. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Amen.
You know what, Teacher Grace?
Yes, George.
I don't have to cry anymore.
You feel strong enough?
No, I will not cry.
Good.
I think I'm going to ask my friend Jesus to wipe away my tears.
Amen.
And Brian's.
Uh-huh.
And of course, the mommy and daddy.
Yes.
Who have been so sad.
Uh-huh.
I will tell them we have a friend.
Yes.
Who knows how to wipe away tears.
Awesome.
Can I go and tell them that?
Yes, you can go. And I'm so proud of you, George. Make sure that you visit them and encourage them.
I will.
Share with them the words mm-hmm. that we've been learning from the Bible.
Yeah.
So that they can find peace and hope in God.
Yes, I will.
Thank you. God bless you.
God bless you. And all my boys and all my friends out there.
Yes.
May the Lord be with you. I will be seeing you soon. Let me go and comfort Brian.
Okay, thank you.
See you.
See you, George. God bless you. A good week.
Okay.
Thank you, boys and girls, for staying tuned. We honor you and we thank you for everything that you're doing. May God keep you safe. And we pray that we'll be able to be together again next Sunday. A lovely week. God bless you.